think about the generations and to say we want to make it a better place for our children and our children's children so that they know it's a better world for them and think they can make it a better place.
There's a place in your heart, and I know that it is love. And this place is much brighter than tomorrow. And if you really try, you'll find there's no need to cry. In this place, you feel there's no hurt or sorrow. There are ways to get there if you care enough for the living. Make a little space, make a better place. Heal the world, make it a better place for you and for me and the entire human race. There are people dying if you care enough for
awareness against disaster. This International Day of Disaster Risk Reduction was started in the year 1989 after a call by UN General Assembly for a day to promote a global culture of risk awareness and disaster reduction. Keeping with the day focused on the impact disasters have on people's life and well-being, this year's theme is about conveying the message that many disasters can be avoided or prevented if there are disasters risk reduction strategies in place to manage and reduce existing levels of risks and to avoid the creation of new risks. What that amounts to is good disaster risk governance. The relevance of the World Calamity Day is an opportunity to acknowledge the progress being made towards reducing disasters risk and losses in life, livelihoods, and health in line with the entire framework for disaster risk reduction adopted in the 3rd UN World Conference for Disaster Risk Reduction in Japan in March 2015. The 2021 target is to sustainably increase the number of countries with national and local disaster risk reduction strategies by 2025, which lays the foundation for the implementation of ideal framework and closely linked with priority to strengthening disaster risk governance to manage disaster risk. Awareness, education, preparedness, prediction, and warning systems can reduce the disruptive impacts of a natural disaster on communities. Mitigation methods such as adoption of zoning, land use practices, and building ports are needed to prevent or reduce the actual damage from hazards, avoiding development in landslides and flood-blown areas through planning and zoning water bodies may save money in construction, reduce the loss of life and damage to property and natural resources.